transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonically transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm. Our programs are produced entirely in the USA and read by professional narrators who are compensated for their services at prevailing union rates. We hope you enjoy this program. The Wizard King. Compiled by Andrew Lang. Narrated by Wes Talbot. In very ancient times, there lived a king whose power lay not only in the vast extent of his dominions, but also in the magic secrets of which he was master. After spending the greater part of his early youth in pleasure, he met a princess of such remarkable beauty that he at once asked her hand in marriage, and having obtained it, considered himself the happiest of men. After a year's time, a son was born, worthy in every way of such distinguished parents, and much admired by the whole court. As soon as the queen thought him strong enough for a journey, she set out with him secretly to visit her fairy godmother. I said secretly, because the fairy had warned the queen that the king was a magician. And as from time immemorial there had been a standing feud between the fairies and the wizards, he might not have approved of his wife's visit. The fairy godmother, who took the deepest interest in all the queen's concerns, and who was much pleased with the little prince, endowed him with the power of pleasing everybody from his cradle, as well as with a wonderful ease in learning everything which could help to make him a perfectly accomplished prince. Accordingly, to the delight of his teachers, he made the most rapid progress in his education, constantly surpassing everyone's expectations. Before he was many years old, however, he had the great sorrow of losing his mother, whose last words were to advise him never to undertake anything of importance without consulting the fairy under whose protection she had placed him. The prince's grief at the death of his mother was great, but it was nothing compared to that of the king, his father, who was quite inconsolable for the loss of his dear wife. Neither time nor reason seemed to lighten his sorrow, and the sight of all the familiar faces and things about him only served to remind him of his loss. He therefore resolved to travel for change, and by means of his magic art was able to visit every country he came to see under different shapes, returning every few weeks to the place where he had left a few followers. Having traveled from land to land in this fashion without finding anything to rivet his attention, it occurred to him to take the form of an eagle, and in this shape he flew across many countries and arrived at length in a new and lovely spot, where the air seemed filled with the scent of jessamine and orange flowers, with which the ground was thickly planted. Attracted by the sweet perfume, he flew lower and perceived some large and beautiful gardens filled with the rarest flowers, and with fountains throwing up their clear waters into the air in 100 different shapes. A wide stream flowed through the garden, and on it floated richly ornamented barges and gondolas, filled with people dressed in the most elegant manner and covered with jewels. In one of these barges sat the queen of that country with her only daughter, a maiden more beautiful than the day star, and attended by the ladies of the court. No more exquisitely lovely mortal was ever seen than this princess, and it needed all an eagle's strength of sight to prevent the king being hopelessly dazzled. He perched on the top of a large orange tree, whence he was able to survey the scene and to gaze at pleasure on the princess's charms. Now an eagle with a king's heart in his breast is apt to be bold, and accordingly he instantly made up his mind to carry off the lovely damsel, feeling sure that having once seen her, he could not live without her. He waited till he saw her in the act of stepping ashore when, suddenly swooping down, he carried her off before her equerrian attendants had advanced to offer her his hand. The princess, on finding herself in an eagle's talons, uttered the most heartbreaking shrieks and cries. But her
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.